Good morning, Grandpa. I have an idea. And I'm getting a call. Hold on one second.
Good morning, Pollard family. Just watching the TV today and thinking about the things that's happened over the last couple weeks, the way the country is in such turmoil about George Floyd's death and everything, caused me to think, what is the root cause of all the problems? And I've come up with something I think that everyone needs to think about. What I've come up with is the phrase, it's all about respect. All our problems we've had stem from respect. So all the problems are about respect. Respect for authority, respect for one another, respect for property, respect for everything. So when we lose respect, how all these looters could just go ahead and break into stores they don't respect. I mean, there's no respect for the police, there's no respect for authority, there's no respect for mother and father, there's no respect for the world. Until we, me, I, everyone, respects one another's right to be who they are, what they are, why they are. When the disrespect comes, then the problems come. So if one another, we can just talk to one another with respect of who they are and what they are and why they are, I think our world would be a lot better place. So I think each one of us should put on our tongues the phrase, it's all about respect.
Okay, Grandpa, here's my idea. You know that awesome thing that Dalen put together of your words about respect? Let me tell you what I think everybody loves about that, because everybody loves that. Did you know it's been viewed over 700 times on Facebook alone? I don't know how many times it's been viewed on YouTube. I think Dalen put it on YouTube. I haven't checked that. I've shared it. Dolly shared it. Other people have shared it. It's everywhere. It's really inspirational. We really love your words about respect and what's going on in our world today. And then I remembered about this little memo. Hi, Crystal. These two books are among my favorites, of course. Salesman number one is The King. Remember the Scrolls have seeped into your other mind, and you can call on your memory at any time to see you through the rough times. Always remember, you are a Pollard girl. Love always, Grandpa. And I love it, love it, love it. Thank you, thank you, thank you. That was written on March 12th. So that is where I'm trying to draw you back to, when you were in this mind of yours with all of these awesome words of how words in our life affect us. And I don't know what you think about this idea that I have. I'm going to share it with you anyway. We've got words to live by: Toyota, satisfaction, expectation, anticipation, obligation, demand, service, rewards, waste, promise, anxious, disappointment, forgiveness, giving, repentance, remuneration, love, okay, excellence, responsibility, respect. So that was a Keva word. So you did one of Keva's words, right? You've got more words on here. You've got maligned, habit, try, help, favor, opportunity, endow. I want you to hear what I'm saying here, Grandpa. I'm like full of ideas, okay? Here's my thing. This was your idea, and I want to take your idea and blossom it like... I don't like getting interrupted. Sorry. I want to take your idea and blossom your idea into something beautiful like Dalen did for you. So here's what my idea is. Let's take Dalen's idea and your idea and my idea. Look at all these words. And Marco Polo is going to help us. And here's what I'd like you to do. I want to challenge you with one word a day. So if I say, hi, Grandpa, today's word today is expectation. And then you come back on Marco Polo like you did with the word respect, and you tell me your opinion of expectation, your views, your values, what you think of it, what your ideas are on expectation, what other people think expectation is, whatever you want to say. I think what really struck a nerve with a lot of your kids and grandkids and why they really love it and why it's been viewed over 700 times, not just by your family, but by the outside world, I think it's because it was your thoughts. You weren't quoting anybody. You weren't reciting things from the Bible. You weren't talking somebody else's words. You gave us your words, and you are a very wise man with a lot of great thoughts and wisdom and knowledge. And I think if I challenged you with one word a day and you come on Marco Polo and speak to me about the word expectation, for example, maybe the next day could be accountability. The next day can be promises, or I don't know what, because I'm looking at all these words here. We could just do one word a day. You can choose your word. I can challenge you with the word, whatever you want me to do. I'm just kind of your administrator of this idea that you had to get this out, to get words that we live by out, okay? I'm trying to like, let's rocket your idea into the world, okay? And here's why I'm thinking we do it in Marco Polo. Because I want to get your words and your ideas about these words. And if you'd give me just one a day, soon we'll have a huge collection, kind of like series in a TV show. You know how they have one TV show a week or one TV show a day or whatever? Soon we will have episode one, episode two, episode three. Episode one is respect. Episode two is about expectations. Episode three is about service, or whatever word we want to use for each episode, right? So I think I'm speaking like in crazy thoughts and ideas. They're all coming at me at once. But you give those to me, make it 5 minutes, 8 minutes, 10 minutes, whatever time frame you think would be good to get your message across, but not too long where it's going to lose people or, you know, become too preachy or whatever, however you want to do it. And then I'll take it and I will do like Dalen did. And we can maybe even enlist Dalen's help, where we can get the different images and the different things that kind of support what you're talking about. So it's not just your face talking the whole time. And we could put the music in the background, and we can start a grandpa channel on YouTube if you want, where it's just about these episodes, grandpa, you know, words we live by. That could be the name of the channel. And it can be, you know, just you spreading your message, right, to the world. And then the other thing I want to do is type what you're saying and still create your book, Words We Live By. Chapter 1, Respect. Chapter 2, Expectations. Chapter 3, Service. And I want to put these in your, I want to type exactly, dictate exactly what you're saying and put it in a book and then have the book printed. Maybe we print 100 books and you can pass them out like candy at Christmas time if you want. This is just my ideas going, okay? This is just my energy flowing. However you want to do it, I'm just your admin coming up with ideas on how to make your thing brought to life. The thing that you wanted to do on March 12th, you were excited about this. I remember this, okay? Now, a couple of rules. When you Marco Polo to me, if you want to do this, when you Marco Polo me and you want to talk to me about expectations, just do me a favor and turn your camera, your phone, sideways like this. If you can turn it sideways like this, then people can watch on a computer screen, they can watch on Facebook, they can watch like this, and that way we can mix it better. It's not a big deal if you don't, or if you forget about it, it's not a huge deal. But if you can, we get a better, we can work with it better. Dalen and I can do different things, okay? The other thing, the other rule is don't address me. Don't talk to me as if Crystal's asking about expectations. Don't bring up, you know, my life or my, me specifically or stuff about my dad. Don't address me. Address the world. So you're Marco Poloing me, but you're addressing the world. Does that make sense? And three, I guess you can just speak from your heart. Don't talk about what you're, what other people are saying or what other people are doing. I mean, you can use those as examples, right? But I think what people are wanting to hear is what you have to say. And so if you go off on a tangent of what other people say or quoting verses from the Bible or quoting Ogmandino or whatever, maybe a quote or two might be good. But if you just speak from your heart, that's what people want to hear. That's what your message is what you think about stuff. You can say, oh, I agree with what Ogmandino says about, you know, being reborn in the skin, you know, shedding your old skin and being reborn. I really agree with that. And this is why I agree with that. People want to hear that. I want to hear that. Dalen wants to hear that. Dolly wants to hear that. Everybody that I've talked to about your video wants to hear what you have to say. And that's why they love this video that Dalen made about respect, is because your words were so powerful, but then the music and the imagery made it even more powerful. So that's what I want to do with all of this. I want to create a really long thing, a really long binge watching series, but 5 minutes at a time, so people can just get their taste of Theron every day or every week or however long we want to do this. Okay, I think I have rambled enough. That was my idea. Tell me what you think of my idea. I've got a lot of passion behind my ideas, so be gentle if you don't like my idea. I love you. I'll talk to you later. Putting it back in the envelope. Bye-bye.
Yeah, I like your idea. Yes, I do, Crystal. It's got a lot of potential, I think. Grandpa's words we live by or something, you know. Hi, this is Grandpa Theron. I thought to put my name in there, probably Grandpa Theron, so that they know which grandpa this is. But yeah, I like your idea. I'll have to ponder on it tonight as I'm in bed laying there. What would I first word be? You know? This is Grandpa Theron going to embark on words we live by, whether we like it or not. Anyway. Okay, sweetie. Yeah, let's embellish on that. I think it's got some good potential. And it could... It could help people. That's all we're here for, to help people be happy. And it should also help me be happy, too. Okay, sweetheart, thank you, and we'll talk to you again. Bye.
Hey, Grandpa. And good morning, because it's about midnight where I'm at. And by the time you watch this, it'll probably be in the wee morning hours. I wonder how you felt after you slept on it. I wonder if you are inspired like I am to get started right away, or are you wanting to sit on it a little bit more? I'm just going to remind you, we need to act now. Act now, act now, act now. I'm just teasing. I'm just teasing. I know you know it, but I want it to be inspired work. If you feel inspired to do it, if you feel like it's your right thing, don't force it. Grandpa's words to live by. I think if you introduce yourself as, you know, hi, this is Grandpa Theron. Yeah, I think introducing it, but I don't think we need to name it Grandpa's words to live by. It can just be words to live by. I don't know. That's just my thought. Because Grandpa's words to live by makes it sound like these are what Grandpa's words are and that he lives by them. But words to live by insinuates that they're everybody's words. you know, and that anybody can adopt them. Anybody can, kind of like the God memorandum. It's not Ogmandino's God memorandum. It's not Ogmandino's 10 scrolls. It's just the 10 scrolls. You can adopt them, right? I don't know. That was my thought. Does that make sense? Because they're already going to know that you're the one that's presenting them. And maybe you'll have inspiration of words that came from others, right? They're not all just your words. I don't know. What am I saying? I'm saying words to live by. Yeah. Also, oh, that's what I was going to say. This also kind of gives you an opportunity to do three things in one. You get to do your performance. You like to perform. You're an entertainer. One. Two, you've always wanted to write a book, so we can write a book. And three, it also gives you a chance to do grandpa's school, because you're teaching them what you're wanting to teach them and help them by using the words to that we live by. You're not teaching them 2 plus 2. You're not teaching them how to count back money. You're not teaching them about the church or the, you know, 10 commandments or whatever. You're teaching the words we live by, which can be a variety of things, variety of words. Anyways, I'm really inspired by it. I'm excited. And I don't know. Let me know what you woke up thinking about this morning. And we'll talk to you later. Love you. Bye.
Hi, sweetheart. Yep, it's not Grandpa's words and phrases. No, not even for a minute. No, never did think of that way. But I've thought of the title of it, Words We Live By, but remember I added phrases, words and phrases we live by, because a lot of times it takes more than just one word, because we get into phrases and we come into those things that, you know, like do unto others as others do unto you. And then a phrase like that, you know. Anyway, nope. I'm pretty excited about it too, Crystal. I've been thinking, you know, it's really strange that the word that you used when you described what my thought should be in this new venture we're talking about is expectations. Really, when I first started thinking about this one day before Lean passed away, when I was all hyped up and excited about this, that word expectations was one of the very first words I ever came up with that I thought was important, you know, expectations, how important it is in our life that we have expectations and they're not too high, and why we're disappointed with our expectations, you know. And the only reason that I came up with that word, the very first word that I ever thought of when I thought about expectations, was talking to you and your expectations with Jim and his expectations of you and all these things. And that's the very first word I ever thought of when I thought about my doing a book thing, you know, expectations. And I talk to people about that word when I start thinking about the expectations I have with some of my grandchildren and my children and my wives and the expectations that I had that caused me disappointment, caused me hard feelings, is because of my expectations, you know. Was I expecting too much? Were they expecting too much? And even as I look about my life and my people and my business and everything, it's all about expectations. and what we expect of each other, what we expect of our customers, what we expect of our bank, what we expect of everything. We have these expectations. And are and when are they fulfilled? Here, I'm talking to you about this now, and I should be on my Marco Polo with my family doing this, but I'm talking to you. But that's, and it surprises me when you're telling me about your idea about me doing this on a periodic basis, that you had that word yourself to talking to me about, and that you had expectations as your demonstrated word. Anyway, that's what I want to do. I want to use that as my starting, as my kickoff word, and I'll get on Marco Polo as soon as I can to start that off. And it's just going to be Grandpa Theron. Hi, Grandpa Theron here. All my family and friends that are here on Marco Polo are going to just expound a couple, a word that I thought about for a long time, and see, when I was so hyped up about my words and phrases, remember I called everybody on the phone and talked to them about it, and you got all excited. Anyway, I need to get back in that mode, but my business, my all of the complexities that, see, my other store that I've opened back up again, I mean, it's not doing great, but it's doing okay. But people come into there, and I'm digging into stuff that hasn't been looked at for several years. Merchandise that I bought, and then I look on the dates. I'll put the date on a display of product, and it'll be back in 5 years ago, 6 years ago. One in 2005. What? Why have I still got product from 2005 that has never been put out on the floor? Why have I got them stacked up like that? And I got a truckload coming in on Friday from Dollar General. I bought a whole truckload of Dollar General merchandise. What's it going to be? I don't know. Stuff Dollar General sells. It'll be a lot of stuff. I know I have bought some at Darren's Auction down in Salt Lake. There's an auction. They have it every week. They have an auction, and they sell pallets and pallets of product. And I've been down there a couple times. I brought two Penske trucks full of stuff home. You know, just merchandise and just stuff. And I go down there to the auction, and holy mackerel, they sell stuff. And I think, oh, man, buy that, sell it, make money. Oh, dear. There's Theron expectations. And I've gotten some pallets of Dollar General merchandise from there. They'll sell it for $100, $150 for the whole pallet of merchandise. Got a whole pallet of clothes, a whole pallet. Well, it wasn't a whole pallet. It was like maybe six or eight boxes. They were dresses, mostly dresses. Dresses and swimsuits and summer stuff and shoes. And, oh, man, this last load, I got a whole pallet of shoes, summer shoes, little kids' shoes and little flip-flops and boys' tennis shoes and all these shoes. My heck, so many shoes. Flip-flops and the whole pallet of shoes for $200, the whole pallet. Anyway, but that's been my business, is buy and sell stuff. But when I don't sell it fast enough, it starts piling up. Now see, Vegas is coming up again in August, but are they going to even have the show in August? They haven't determined yet, but their people are canceling. One of the fairs here in Idaho was canceled. The Western Idaho State Fair was canceled. Are they going to cancel the Eastern Idaho State Fair? They haven't made that determination yet, but This is only a couple of months away. July, August, September, and the Eastern Idaho State Fair is supposed to be on. And the ASD show in August, the first week in August, the ASD show is supposed to happen again when Theron goes and gets four semi-trailers worth of merchandise. What in the world? The expectations of all those vendors that I buy from is that Theron Pollard will be there to get my stuff. And I built that relationship with all these vendors all these years when they don't have to worry a bit. They just know that Theron will be there with his crew to get my stuff. And I really feel an obligation. Now, after expectations, then comes obligation, the word obligation. Oh, dear. See how many words we have that just make our life work. Expectation, obligation, implementation. Oh, so many words that cause our life to work or not work. Obligation, expectation. Wow. Anyway, I could sit here and chat a long time, but I got to get to work. I got a doctor appointment this morning, so I got to get cleaned up for that. Love you, sweetheart. Don't lose faith. Like you said, I will act now. I will act now. I will act now. Actually, those are Hafid's. Well, that's not Hafid's words. Those are Ogmandino's words he put in that scroll, which are really, really important. Well, all those scrolls are important. I'm sure you find yourself now as you go through life. Oh, man, that's that scroll. That's that scroll. That's that. And people that you know, people that you associate with, what are their expectations? What are their obligations? What, holy mackerel, words and phrases we, you, me, and everybody live by. Even the word death, we have to live by that too, as sad as it makes us. All right, sweetheart. Well, you take care, and we'll talk again. Bye.